story and let them know that I'm sorry. I used to love this part of death, but now the reaper's upon me and shit, I'm scared. Save me, mom, I'm passing away. I wish I didn't put that bullet through the back of my brain. They go again, harassing his kid so easily. His name is Andy, he grew up right down the street from me. I barely know him, though I just see him in school while passing him. Usually followed by two kids giggling in back of him. I don't know why they feel the need to interfere, and I'll be honest. The kid is obviously a little weird. He's got a stutter for souls, talks to himself. But it is clear to me they shouldn't mess with him. He probably wish they disappear, like, yeah, he's different. So, he ain't causing harm to anyone. Yeah, he might annoy him, not on purpose, though. He's never done something intentionally offensive like these other kids, like yelling, stop being a retard when they see a mumbling or call him a faggot when he's saying something awkward. Yeah, he lives with it, but he shouldn't have to any longer. He's just a kid like any of us. Matter of fact, next time I see it, I'ma say something and have his back. It's worse because people accept it as they become used to it, and he don't stand up. But what can you do with the hate against you? You call him out, you call this bad with some anger issues. They hear, but they don't listen. It's senseless. They're hearing that bullies are everywhere, thinking that here must be the exception. But it's so alive and it's so true. They got open eyes, but they don't view. They got growing minds that they don't use, and it's pulverizing our whole youth. But to be honest, most of these bullies don't mean any harm. They're just kids like any of us. They like to be in charge, they like attention, they just lack guidance in getting it. So they put others down. None of us are always innocent, but that don't make it right. Cause again, I'm watching Andy get tortured by two of his peers with no reason in sight. And I know he knows I'm watching, he sees me paying attention, and it's getting worse and worse. I hope he knows that I respect him. Two kids who've been messing with him, but without a target, both of them just blended right in. 20 minutes later, the class was pretty quiet. As Andy walked through the door, he was shaking and crying. As all heads slowly in sync turn, he pauses and pulls a pistol out of his front pocket. The girl screamed, the boy sat there terrified. Nobody expected this, but everyone knew the reason why. And before anyone could say something fully, within seconds, two bullets flew into his bullies. Both screams as the bodies collapsed. I felt I should say something because I was the only one who had his back. I said, it's over, Andy, they're dead. You had your wish. He turned to me and said, you were the third on my list.
ripped jacket with the stains on his surface. He was the kid that everyone was happy they weren't, sitting alone, invisible to every passing person. Wondering what it would feel like to have a purpose. He never had a childhood, forced to parent his own parents like no child should. His father is a veteran, drowning his memories with liquor, and his mother's taking pills like doctors give her, but they only make him sicker. With no sibling to walk through the stuff, no hands, no money, no friends, no buddies, he ain't talking enough. He don't put himself out there, he's offered too much wealth. Who in his life would he learn that confidence from? And he sits behind me in class. One day I heard him crying from the back. Finally I turned around and I asked what was wrong. The first time I heard his voice, he said, all I know is pain. If this is life, what's the point? Show me what happiness is. His voice drew me, he looked through me. He said, show me what happiness is. Desperateness in his face, I didn't know what to say. I couldn't think, show me what happiness is. He put his head down and he didn't make a sound. Show me what happiness is. And I just froze, like I don't even know. Perfect makeup, even though she don't need the extra touch. She was a girl that every other girl was jealous of. Silky hair, blue eyes, thin body with curves, but her new clothes only cover parts of it. She's almost looked at like a goddess to all. Attracts every pair of eyes when she walks through the hall. But she's likable too, she's not the one to gossip. Evident when you talk to her, she ain't ever pompous. Wealthy home, filled with knowledge and newness. She was the youngest out of three book smart students, and her parents were so proud, pride was all around her. But I always noticed something was a little off about her. She sits in front of me in class. One day I noticed heavy makeup on her wrist when she passed papers back. After class, I approached her and I asked about it. She said, it don't mean I have it if I'm around her. Show me what happiness is. Then I looked into her eyes, I saw her for the first time. Show me what happiness is. I saw regret, she walked away in a sec. Her voice rang through my head, show me what happiness is. I watched her walk away, she became another face. What she say, show me what happiness is. And I just froze, like I don't even know. I don't know, because I ask myself the same thing every single day, but every single answer has been vague. How come some appreciate the sun after the rain, while others just see the puddles as if nothing has changed? And as I watch people living a life I couldn't take, I wonder if they see a way out mentally. And as I watch people living a life I idolize, I wonder what they feel and what isn't seen. As I watch my whole family take pills for depression, I wonder what true happiness really means. I wonder if because I'm genetically predisposed to it, that is the reason I find myself feeling weak. Only sometimes in and out, I guess it's scarier when you don't have a reason to be feeling down. Sometimes I just am. Sometimes I just feel no one will ever understand. Sometimes I wanna cry. Sometimes I wanna cross my family's so-called medication, look in their eyes and tell them they don't need it as long as we just have each other. But then sometimes I want them to suffer. I just wonder where happiness is. Show me where happiness is.
YouTube Music. Temukan playlist yang sesuai dengan mood kamu. Dari lagu hit saat ini sampai lagu untuk suasana hati yang lagi happy. Download YouTube Music.
Giving that shit, I just wanna be like. cause she looked good and she didn't buy it. She went back to the bathroom, I backed up and peeked inside and never seen her so focused, painting her face with a brush. You can paint anything you want if you're creative enough. Today she painted happy, took like an hour 50. She wanna be a model, to finally be pretty. Shit, why can't she do it? She know how to code. Daddy doesn't get it, she said cause he's old. He said it's not a job unless it pays. So she got photographer to show her how she lay. He gets her money and friends. Pop it up, post it up, get your money paid. Oh, look at her bio, see a model slash fitness slash motivation slash queen slash entrepreneur, so do not call her a hoe. The classy shit did not get the attention that she hoped, and she knows. One light equals one pair, and when it's dark time, one light equals one flare, and when the stocks rise, one light equals one share, and when my mom dies, one light equals one prayer, and when the rent's due,
one light equals one friend.
And the landlord is a hater if he doesn't understand. Fuck it, man.
Latte, latte.
Barista akhirnya bis mengklaim dirinya barista dan
dan aing mah diakui sama yang punya ya juga kan dites dulu.
Cinta apa nih?
Gelis pisan, asli sumpah itu bohong nih. Pas Rio lewat lah, lewat 10 kali.
Terus mana fucking the office gitu? Hah? Fucking the office enggak kan?
Pengen sih gitu.
Pengen apa tuh? Barista. Tapi enak ngebel mending kumpul. Oh, my grandpa died at home and only to remind me every day above the ground is a blessing. I didn't pick up because I was underground in the
place. No service. Oke. Okay.
No karakter terayun
asli. Karakter mulai. Karakter mulai. Dan mau tekin kan badan. Aing
Jatuh
cinta tuh ya, jujur lah.
Ini please, pasti kita ilmu dan ngerana-ngerana. kita bilang bisa biasanya lewat itu jadi juga kumaha gitu ini
salah mau calon barista no air lah ayah wew tak parek pun
bisa lu ayah penasaran ya
penasaran tapi tadi saja nyawa ada mana mulai dari itu sama last
post solo ini saya ini coverage man no one thinks I need a visit no one thinks I need a face sama bro no one now my brother bisa mampir ke lebar seorang mailman in my house more than anybody that I know today
sad, sad boy, sad boy.
Atau mana yang inisiatif mau
orang ada? Inisiatif orang mulai susunan mulai ada
oh nyimpen itu tuh
jadi mulai ajar mau gagal kan bisa dibawa orang
oh jadi mana yang diajar pakai pintu saya kan kalau yang pakai pintu itu terus anu yang kan yang ke konsumen pakai pintu itu jadi itu jadi mana mana di dua barat
kira video callan kira
iyalah
akhirnya
kira kita belum tidur kan nungguin kopi ya besok libur
udah tidur tadi ya ngorok sampai kasihan aja
gak boleh main mau americano kan
Bispak tuh aja. Emang pemain wasit garanteng anjing.
Kan biasanya kan barista ini garanteng, Bro. Emang Pak Gan sama pemain basket pasti lah garanteng.
Emang Michael Jordan ganteng.
Kaya. Jordan itu Jordan aja punya Michael Jordan ganteng. Tapi emang
sensi goblok
coba bisa gitu
I don't know. kalau nah ondan tuh
dari kamar ini cenai pelonggan mereka itu tuh tahu isu
aing mikir mah ah Jakarta awal lah ningali si Reja gawe juga
Hari aing gawe di hut mah eueuh nu kahut anjing. Tapi udah sebenernya mah, nu bener mah buah heula karek dahar sih.
Ya sih, sebenernya mah.
Ini kan
budaya Indonesia,
beli
daun budaya Indonesia.
Ayang atau aing, anjing. Gak buka ketan iya
aing. Ada anjing!
Tunggu manual kan gue ya. Pake emang kasih dulu.
Uang razia aja ya.
Uang harap. Uang razia aja. Asli anjing. Uang razia itu
beli. Aing nyepikin kata di maghrib ya, karak sehari aing. Ja, mana tu loyal gitu, ja? Tu loyal. Hah? Nah, letik aimut nyeri, aimut nyeri. Wes, yo wes. the fuck? Fool, what the fuck?
We still acting like that's good enough, but I'm been blowing them off like a business.